In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good to see you this morning. Brothers and sisters, there's a document called the Didache from 60 AD, where it says, at the beginning of Mass, we first confess our sins. And it acts like that had been the long tradition in 60 AD. So since the time of the apostles, we have first begun Mass by asking God to touch our hearts with his forgiveness and pardon so that we would be more open to his grace during the Mass, which is the one thing Jesus asked us to do together in our prayer. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life. And let us pray. I'm doing a special Mass for the precious blood. O God, who by the precious blood of your only begotten Son have redeemed the whole world, preserve in us the work of your mercy, so that ever honoring the mystery of our salvation, we may merit to obtain its fruits. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, the priest of Bethel, sent word to Jeroboam, king of Israel. Amos has conspired against you here with Israel. The country cannot endure all his words. For this is what Amos says: Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel shall surely be exiled from its land. To Amos, Amaziah said, off with you, visionary, flee to the land of Judah. There, earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary and a royal temple. Amos answered Amaziah, I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, go, prophesy to my people Israel. Now hear the word of the Lord. You say, prophesy not against Israel, preach not against the house of Isaac. Now thus says the Lord, your wife shall be made a harlot in the city, and your sons and daughters shall fall by the sword. Your land shall be divided by measuring line, and you yourself shall die in an unclean land. Israel shall be exiled far from its land. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. They are more precious than gold, than a heap of purest gold, sweeter also than syrup or honey from the comb. The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
And my brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After entering a boat, Jesus made the crossing and came into his own town. And there people brought to him a paralytic lying on a stretcher. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Courage, child, your sins are forgiven." At that, some of the scribes said to themselves, "This man is blaspheming." Jesus knew what they were thinking and said, "Why do you harbor evil thoughts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or 'Rise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he then said to the paralytic, "Rise, pick up your stretcher, and go home." He rose and went home. When the crowd saw this, they were struck with awe and glorified God who had given such authority to men. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you. Well, today you have Amos in the Old Testament from the book of the prophet Amos being criticized, and then Jesus also. In both cases, they're being someone's questioning whether they truly are speaking for God. In the case of the prophet Amos, it's interesting. Amaziah, a priest of Bethel, that was a center of Jewish prayer at that time, says to Amos, "Earn your bread by prophesying." And that was an insult, because at the time, there was a whole class of people who called themselves prophets, and they were sort of discredited in the eyes of many people. They wanted to make money off of telling people, you know, what God had said. And they actually, it was considered to be at the time a bit of a scandal. These people go, they said, bands. B-A-N-D-S, bands of prophets, oftentimes not thought well of. They just wanted to make money through religion. Good thing that doesn't happen today. Anyway, so when he says this, Amos answers, basically he's saying, "I was called by God. I didn't want to do this." He says, "I was no prophet," like one of those, "nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores." And actually, I even looked this up years ago. In Israel at the time, I don't know about today, there was, if you took it's not the same kind of sycamore tree that we have, different kind of tree. And if you splice it, et cetera, it produces a rather large fruit. And if you don't do dress the sycamore, it has a little tiny fruit. So that's something that he did. But he's basically saying, "I was called into this. I'm sincere." And today I was just thinking about just that one thought. You know, all of us are called to be prophets. And today, in our time and place, in Western culture, in the year 2020, we're born into a cynical world. People are sometimes weary, sometimes they're suspicious or cynical about whatever it is, God or institutions. So I always thought that if we're going to get through to people today, at least a lot of people are going to see, they're going to be open to what we have to say only if they see we're living out our faith. You know, so today Jesus and Amos, people are suspicious of them. They're not wanting to credit them with speaking for God. I think for us, if we want to get through to people, they're going to have to see through how kind we are, through how we help those who are vulnerable or in need, through how fair we are. I think, how do we break through to a cynical world? We really have to be on our toes and really obviously living out our faith to break through that wall of cynicism today. So let's pray that people, as they say, see the good works that we do and give praise to the Lord because of them. Going to invite you also, tomorrow we're having, it's going to be a little warm out there, but we have some ideas cooked up, little tents we're going to put outside in front of the church, tents, and can I say this? It's a good deal about the fans with the vapor? Okay, like cooling fans that have water vapor. So we're going to have those out front. We're having adoration for the healing of our nation. Tomorrow, July 3rd, 3 p.m. to 7:30. From 6 to 7, there'll be live music happening as well. And the rest of the time, just quiet prayer. And, of course, some of the normal prayers. There'll be a rosary and Divine Mercy Chaplet, starting at 3, Mercy Chaplet. So if you want to stop in for a little bit, I don't expect you to bake for, well, we will have tents. I don't expect you to be out there for 4.5 hours, but it's an opportunity to pray for our country, for healing, for God to bring his grace and peace upon our nation at this time. Tomorrow, July 3rd, 3 to 7:30 p.m. And everyone online, invite you, it's going to be outside. So if you're concerned about anything, come on down. And let us offer our prayers.
That the Lord may keep watch over his church, growing her in holiness and virtue, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace of Christ may heal divisions and bring an end to violence throughout the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the compassion and mercy of Christ may free all who suffer from any physical or spiritual burden, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit may help us live faithfully our commitment to the teachings of Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our most gracious Father may welcome into his heavenly kingdom all the faithful departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And for all those prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts and lift up to the Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we ask all these prayers through Christ our Lord. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Thank you. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. And pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May. As we offer our oblation to your majesty, O Lord, may we draw near in these mysteries to Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant, and celebrate anew the sprinkling of his blood, in which lies all our salvation through Christ our Lord. And my brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty, since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. He who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body." Which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith: when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and to bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For it is through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. But deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God. And my brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, and we'll now do a spiritual communion for those watching online. Lord Jesus, I know you are fully present in the most blessed sacrament of the Holy Mass. While I cannot receive you physically at this time, I now ask you to enter into my heart for a spiritual communion. And let us pray. Refreshed, O Lord, by this saving food and drink, we pray that we may always be bathed in the blood of our Savior, so that it may become for us a spring of water welling up to eternal life through Christ our Lord. Hope you all have a good day. Let's pray for one another today. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ. St. Michael.